Events are essential for Google Chat apps. Why? Imagine a user asking for your chat app to block out the day in their calendar. That interaction triggers an event to be sent from Google Chat to your app. Every time a user interacts with your chat app, an event is passed from Google Chat to your app, containing the details of the interaction in the request body as a JSON payload. On screen, you can see a simple hello message by the chat app user Luca. This message results in a payload being sent to the app, containing information like the message sent, the actual text, the space it was sent in, and so on. There are four events that can be passed from Google Chat to your app. Added to space indicates that your app was added to a chat space. Typically, you would have your app respond to this event by sending a welcome message to the space. Removed from space indicates that your chat app was removed from a chat space. Apps don't respond to this event because they're no longer part of that chat space. The event message represents a message sent from a user to the app. Note that the app will never receive a message event sent by itself or from another chat app. The app responds to this event by posting a message in the same thread as the original user message. The fourth and last event is that of card clicked. This event indicates that the user has clicked on an interactive card that the chat app has sent them. An app responds to this event by performing whatever action the user chose, like opening a URL, launching a dialog, or maybe performing one of the app's custom features or actions. This illustration groups the events by messaging types. As you can see, added to space and removed from space are only available for chat apps that are added to chat spaces or group conversations. Your app can respond to the events we previously mentioned by posting messages. Currently, there are two types of messages that your app can post on Google Chat. Subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos about Google Workspace development and AppSheet.